It's the 23rd of October in the deep trench, and we've excavated the timbers from the Viking building. So all we've got left is the construction cut, which is the big rectangular cut with the vertical sides. And we've only got the western end of this building, so we know that the cuts and the timbers continue beyond the edge of the excavation that way, and we'll excavate that sometime in the future. So what we've got left after we've recorded this cut, all of the deposits that the building was cut into. So we know, just looking at the different types of deposits that we can see in the sides of the cut and on and from the top, that there's a very big pit in here that's been cut through by the construction cut for the building. There's another one here which is very clear to see. This is earlier material, and this is the fill of this pit. And you can see it's quite a large feature there. Survives to that height outside the building, and survives much lower down within in the base of the building. And there's another pit there as well. So we're just carrying on now with the stratigraphic excavation of the deposits and the cuts and whatever other structures we'll find that predate the Viking building. Well, it's the 11th of November 2008, excavating the deep trench, and we're now down over 3 metres from the modern ground surface. I'll go down in the trench and show you what we found recently. Now here I'm standing inside the remains of the Viking building that we'd excavated over the past few weeks, and we're now looking at the deposits and the features outside of that building. So over here, I'm now outside the edge of the building. We're down to what appears to be a soil layer, probably Roman in date, but we'll find out when we get the dating evidence. And what you can see in this section, in the side of the trench, is a series of deposits that have been dumped in this area over this soil, which were then cut through by the Viking building and also by these other pits you can see that we've had that predated the Viking building as well. We're not sure what this is at the moment. Some of it may be a soil, and until we get the finds we won't be entirely sure of the date, but we're certainly talking about activity of the Viking period that predates the Viking building, and they'll probably go right the way down to the Roman period. The next thing we'll do will be to excavate this soil layer, and underneath that there'll be undisturbed natural deposits which basically dates back towards the end of the last glaciation about 10,000 years ago. And at that point we will stop the excavation of this trench. We also found a human cranium within the lowest deposit above this soil here, and also disarticulated human bone. So it might well be that there were human burials in this area which have been disturbed, and possibly due to ploughing, but that's one interpretation that we've still got to double check yet. Thank you.